not going to be able to visit. Thank you all for what's contributed to our capital campaign planning statement. It will go a long way in helping us effectively plan for the future of St. Mary Magdalene. If you have yet to contact us, yes, please visit our website and select the link to view project details and fill out the survey. Paper surveys are also located at the church exit this weekend. We hope to receive complete surveys by November 7th. The return of survey to main festival, parish office, and place in the auditory basket at Mass. Welcome Bishop Jerome to our parish this weekend. He is the newly consecrated bishop of the Diocese of St. Thomas and the Virgin Islands. He is friend of our diocese and our parish. Our priest celebrating this evening is Bishop Jerome of Feudjio, and his intention is for Barbara alone. Please stand and read our
You have seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone have the Lord of one. You alone have the Lord. You alone have the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Magdalen. It happened that seven brothers with their mother were arrested and tortured with whips and scourges by the king to force them to report in violation of God's law. One of the brothers, speaking for the other, said, "What do you expect to achieve by questioning us? We are ready to die rather than transgress the laws of our ancestors." At the point of death, he said, "You accursed fiend, you are depriving us of this present life. But the king of the world will raise us up to live again forever. It is for his laws that we are dying." After him, the third suffered their cruel sport. Put out his tongue at once when told to do so, and bravely held out his hands as he spoke these noble words: "It is from heaven that I receive these. For the sake of his laws, I disdain them. For him, I hope to receive them again." Even the king and his attendants marveled at the young man's courage, because he regarded his sufferings as nothing. After he had died, they tortured and maltreated the fourth brother in the same way. When he was near death, he said, "It is my choice to die at the hands of men, with the hope God gives of being raised up by him. But for you, there will be no resurrection to life." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting encouragement and good hope through his grace, encourage your hearts and strengthen them in every good word and deed. Finally, brothers and sisters, pray for us, so that the word of the Lord may speak forward and be glorified as it did among you, and that we may be delivered from perverse and wicked people, for not all have faith. But the Lord is faithful. He will strengthen you and guard you from the evil one. We are confident of you in the Lord that what we instruct you, you are doing and will continue to do. May the Lord direct your hearts to the love of God and to the endurance of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Thank you
very much. Once again, I'm here in this beautiful church. When I arrived here last weekend, Father Jim has made some arrangement for me to go to a parish at St. Elizabeth and Sita. And I was there last weekend. And here I am. We reserve the best for last. Well, upon arriving here, I was warmly welcomed into this warm place. But I was told that, it's not like the Virgin Islands. It's cold. But since I've been here, I have just felt at home. So much so that I feel like calling my people and telling them that I don't want to come back to the Virgin Islands. But I know what I would say. Brothers and sisters, I'm delighted to be here for many reasons. Because the Bishop and Father Jim welcomed me here to speak to you about the Virgin Islands. So I've come here with a message from the Virgin Islands Catholics. But before I deliver that message, if you allow me, I will break open the whole scriptures of this weekend. Since my delivery is to be conducted or done in the context of Sunday liturgy. Brothers and sisters, the readings of today ask us how far we are willing to go in practicing our faith, and also ask us to consider what the next life will be like. In the first reading, a mother and her sons endured torture and death rather than violate the law. So they were persecuted for their faith in God, their willingness and the desire to stick to the law of God. And because of that, they suffered and were put to death. So she, the mother, is forced to choose between sacrificing her children and meeting imperial demands. She remains faithful to the covenant of her ancestor, the covenant with God that she trusts with all her heart. The first reading of today will be summarized in these simple words. We must endure and hope. We must endure and hope. The story of the seven brothers is a typical example of how hope can sustain us. What was at stake was more than just eating of pork meat. Rather, it was about God's command and their identity as the people of God. So they faced persecution courageously, because of the hope they had in God's promise of eternal life. It was heaven that gave me these things, they would say. From him, I hope to receive them again. In the second reading of today, Paul prayed for us. He asked God, who equips us with comfort and hope, to strengthen us, you and me, to strengthen us in everything that is good. Paul wrote to a people to encourage them to endure persecutions while hoping in the fulfillment of Christ's promise. Hence, he prays for the strength that will sustain them in their sufferings and hard times. The Lord is faithful and will give you strength and guide you from the evil one. This is our God. A God who is slow to anger and rich in compassion. The God who came to be here, his church. The lesson we must learn from this heroic act is that we must not be afraid of persecution for the sake of our faith in Christ. Rather, we should let the hope we have in eternal life sustain us always. Let us hold on strongly through the book of the prophets, for he who promised is faithful. Brothers and sisters, this is the hope that motivated me to come here. That regardless of what might have happened in my life, I'm speaking to people who are rooted in God, people who have the hearts to understand. I will not return empty-handed. You will hear our calls, and you will certainly pray for us. You will pray for us, and God will answer our prayers. And now, I'm going to speak to you about the Diocese of St. Thomas and the U.S. Virgin Islands. But before I came here, all the time that I come to the United States, mainland, I'm always given a warning. Keep it short. So if you see that I'm not sure,